All right, we're seeing Trump versus Clinton again. This time they're sparring and dueling statements about the outcome of the 2016 election, what caused it. How much responsibility do you think Hillary Clinton needs to take for why she lost? Let's get the bottom line from CNN senior political commentator David Axelrod. It's very interesting. People took what Clinton said very different ways. Some heard her saying, it's on me, but let's not ignore what Comey did and all that stuff. Other people heard her push it away from herself and more on others. What did you hear?
Well, first of all, let me say that the 2016 race was a miserable slog, and nobody in America is eager to relitigate it except the combatants who keep going back to it. But beyond that, she has a legitimate beef because Comey's letter was instrumental, I think, in her defeat. So in a narrow sense, she's right about it. But Jim Comey didn't tell her not to campaign in Wisconsin after the convention. Jim Comey didn't say, don't put any resources into Michigan until the final week of the campaign. And one of the things that hindered her in the campaign was a sense that she never fully was willing to take responsibility for her mistakes, particularly that server. And, so if I were her, if I were advising her, I would say, don't do this. Don't go back and appear like as if you're shifting responsibility off of you. She said the words, I'm responsible, but everything else suggested that she doesn't really feel that way. And I don't think that helps her in the long run. So if I were her, I would move on.
Let's listen to it for one second, because I heard something else in there in addition to what you're saying. So let's listen.
I take absolute personal responsibility. I was the candidate. I was the person who was on the ballot. And I am very aware of, the challenges, the problems, the, shortfalls that we had. Did we make mistakes? Of course we did. Did I make mistakes? Oh, my gosh, yes. You'll read my confession and my request for absolution. But the reason why I believe we lost were the intervening events in the last 10 days.
David, what do you think about the theory that she didn't go further there and sort of flesh it out because she has a book coming out? And she said, you'll read my confessions and my request for absolution, as in, like, that's stay tuned. That's coming up in her book.
Well, look, I think she would have been well served to just stop it before she got to. But the reason I lost, well, it takes a lot of work to lose to Donald Trump. Let me tell you, he was the least popular presidential candidate to win in the history of polling. And so it wasn't just the Comey letter. The fact that she was in a position to lose because of the Comey letter is something that deserves some introspection, and maybe it will come in her book. But if I were her, I would just, if she's got a book coming out, let the book speak for itself and don't get involved in these sidebar conversations.
What do you think about Trump taking the bait and the way that he took the bait, trashing Comey again, saying that the Russia questions are irrelevant again? Does that help him?
Well, look, he knew Comey was testifying today. I'm sure he wanted to use it as an opportunity to go back at this. He is frantic on this subject, and every time it comes up, he's very reactive. She gave him another opportunity to do it. I think with every action and every tweet that this White House takes, they draw more suspicion on themselves. And, but I think we're well past talking about whether a tweet was prudent or not on the part of the president. I mean, he is the mad tweeter, and he'll continue to do what he's doing.
David, let's talk about something that we know.